Today's young buyers have a radically different vision of the world. They demand designs that challenge the norm and revolutionize life on board. And it's this hunger for innovation that underpins the existence of Vreethink. During our annual event, we bring together brilliant minds to share in a completely new approach to yacht design. This is Vreethink's Night Out.
4 years ago, my good friend Philip and I, we saw these pictures on the internet and we thought, wow, we have to make this. This is amazing. Nobody did something with this after the Second World War when this craft was used. So we set out on a mission to recreate it at first, and we did that with a document. And this document we found stashed away in some dusty museum in Plymouth. And it described exactly what was wrong with the craft. And we thought, well, this is perfect. This is like a do-it-yourself how-to, make your own submarine. So we did. And we made a sort of modern representation of it. And it worked really well. It took us a year. Actually, this made the Amsterdam Scheepsvaart Museum as well, which was really proud moment for us. It was crammed full of innovative technologies that all sort of failed one after the other. So it would work for a while and then it would not. But we soon discovered that if we wanted to build a company, we also had to sell one. So my dad and I built a 3D printed three-seater that I just thought up, and we sold one. The first day we went to Abu Dhabi. And we were like, oh, so what are we gonna do now? Well, we know how to 3D print it, so let's 3D print it for real, like true size. So after 1.5 years of really, really hard work and trying all these new ways of building and designing a boat, we came up with a really, really, really nice boat, the Ultimate three-seater, which is this one. And this boat broke some records. It's the fastest commercial sub available. It's like flying on the water, basically. It has wings. It's because it goes so fast that you use the wings to change your depth or direction. You can even roll the craft. And this was like 2 years ago when we finished up. So then the Marines came to our door and they asked us to do something for them as well. But they said, first you have to make a plan on how you're going to do it. And we thought, okay. So we gave them the first plan, and they said no. And 35 times later, they said yes. So it took quite a while. So we designed it. We wanted to design it as quickly and as smartly as possible again, smarter than we did last time. So we used augmented reality for this process. What we basically did was we went from SolidWorks. Somebody drew something in SolidWorks, immediately put it in AR. So we had a little cockpit built around my computer. We could sit in it and you could see the part. You could actually touch it. And we could actually simulate the boat in the water. So you knew exactly if that part you just designed was up for the job. And we managed to finish this entire boat in 8 months instead of 1.5 years it took. So from nothing to certified boat that actually works in 8 months. We even had to create our own computational fluid dynamics simulator, which was my little nerdy project. I love doing that, where we simulate all the water molecules and how they react around the boat. That was kind of a big deal for us because it allowed us to speed up the design process really quickly. So, yeah, after 8 months, it worked. And it immediately worked. We put it in the water and it worked. And that was a huge surprise to us because usually it never works. If you put it in the water the first time, it starts sinking. That's actually the point of this boat, but it didn't start sinking, so that was really good. And so we were kind of surprised by it, and we had a lot of really cool innovations, like we would steer the boat using an Xbox 360 controller instead of the usual handles. It was way easier to pass the controls to the guy in the back who was tapping your shoulder because he wanted to have a go as well. So it was great, and our client, the Navy, really, really enjoyed it. They enjoyed the process immensely because they saw where it was going. And this is our next venture, is putting all kinds of stuff in this boat, like scanners, even to IMAX cameras. We can actually fit a huge IMAX camera in there, so we're actually working with some filmmakers at the moment. I'm not allowed to talk about, but it's really, really cool. It's like our dream come true, basically. We also figured out that this boat can can house a huge plethora of sensors. And these sensors are usually very big. So last year, what we did was we managed to make them smaller and smaller and smaller because we wanted to fit these on the boat or even on the head of a diver. Because if you could do that, you could be sitting in a boat and know exactly what's going on around you. So we developed sonar vision. We stick a sonar to the head of the diver, and you can actually see using sound. And this was quite an invention. We only when we went to Rotterdam for the first time and showed this off to a couple people in the offshore industry, they sort of fell off their chairs like, oh, this is perfect, because we can't see underwater. And we developed underwater augmented reality goggles that can actually use this. Later found out that this would have been perfect to save those Thai boys stuck in the caves, because they couldn't get them out because the visibility was too low. And with this, you could have. So what it entails is, if you put this on your head, we basically remove the limitation of the underwater visibility. So sometimes if you go sailing in the Netherlands, the water is always bad, so it's you always need these. Sometimes you can't even see the nose of your boat, as you can see in this shot. Like, this is what you can see realistically in the Netherlands underwater in wintertime after a rainstorm. And with the goggles on, you can see something way more than that. Not only does it help disorientation, you can see through the water exactly what's going on in front of you up to 200 meters. So this is what you see basically with the goggles on. So that kind of triggered us a little bit, like, wow, you can do so much with this. You can do so much more than just underwater navigation as well. So we're actually working on, because I tried this out in my car as well. And when I stepped in my car was instantly worth much more than when I didn't. So, but this was, I found out that this can also work in cars, but also in aeroplanes. And that's a bit where our next innovation is going to be, probably, is in the vision systems and the sensor integrations. But yeah, so that was what I did last year.